As of September 7th of 2025, there are currently 44 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is one more than were erupting last week. One of the now 10 actively erupting volcanoes within Indonesia is the Dukono volcano, which has been continuously erupting for 92 years straight and counting. Dukono produces fairly frequent volcanic explosions which eject ash and bumps of lava, often throwing them beyond the rim of its currently active crater. As a result, a 4-kilometer exclusion zone from the center of Dukono's active crater is currently in place. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In Chile, a volcano with a very voluminous magma chamber known as Laguna del Maule produced its strongest earthquake swarm on record. This swarm, which is still ongoing even today, produced nearly 5,000, yes, 5,000 volcanic earthquakes in a single day. Meanwhile, at a very famous volcanic island of Japan, specifically Iwo Jima, a new explosive eruption occurred, forming a brand new 518-foot-wide crater and scattering ash across part of the island. And in what is this week's top story, Kilauea produced a new spectacular eruptive episode during which it erupted its most significant amount of lava during a recent 24-hour time span. How much lava? Enough to hypothetically fill the area of an American football field 1 mile high. Kilauea on Hawaii's Big Island has been episodically erupting via this predictable cycle since December 23rd of last year, all of which occurred harmlessly within its summit caldera. So far, 32 eruptive episodes have occurred involving tall lava fountains and hours-long high rates of lava effusion. The 32nd such episode began at 6:35 a.m. on September 2nd, when domed lava fountaining transitioned into a taller lava fountain, outputting fresh molten rock onto the caldera floor. Lava fountains then grew to 330 feet or 100 meters in height, with lava fountains erupting at a horizontal angle of 45 degrees towards the northeast. At 8:20 a.m., the lava fountains slightly changed direction again, rotating counterclockwise to the north-northeast. As these fountains reached a peak height of 492 feet or 150 meters, something interesting happened. Rising hot air from the newly erupted lava created a so-called lava tornado. This is not actually a tornado, but rather a whirlwind, much like a dust devil you would find in a desert. Lava effusion would continue onwards for a total of nearly 13.5 hours before ceasing at 8:01 p.m. local time. In total, 9.6 million cubic meters of lava had erupted, equaling an average lava effusion rate of nearly 200 cubic meters per second. Now, Kilauea's 33rd episode is likely to begin sometime between September 10th and September 18th. Meanwhile, on Japan's island of Iwo Jima, yes, the same one that was the World War II battlefield, a new explosive volcanic eruption began on September 1st. This new eruption occurred on the western middle shoreline of the island, involving a series of phreatomagmatic explosions. These explosions were numerous and in the context of recent Iwo Jima eruptions were unusually large. As a result, a brand new 158 meter or 518 foot wide crater was carved in a hydrothermally altered patch of ground which had not produced a known eruption in historical times. Ash from this series of explosions ended up covering a full 2 square kilometers, also adding debris to the water, turning it light blue. While I cannot confirm that damage to any of the island's structures occurred, it is possible at two such structures due to their proximity to the volcanic eruption which occurred. This marks one of several dozen recent eruptions that have occurred on Iwo Jima in the last few decades as the island continues to rise by about 1.5 meters a year. And in Chile, what was possibly its strongest earthquake swarm on record occurred at another volcanic caldera that has also been experiencing a long-term uplift, Laguna del Maule. Volcanic earthquakes were already occurring at greatly elevated levels of 200 a day, and then, beginning on August 24th, this figure further increased. By August 26th, 500 a day were occurring, more than 1,000 a day on August 31st, 3,000 on September 2nd, and then nearly 5,000 a day on September 3rd and 4th. Well, so many earthquakes in such a short time span might make it sound like Laguna del Maule is about to produce its first eruption in a millennia, an eruption actually isn't likely right now. All of these earthquakes are volcano tectonic with no long period, hybrid, or volcanic tremor events that could indicate new magma movement. Instead, while this is speculative, I suspect that some uplift threshold was reached that caused a series of faults to slip and generate earthquake swarms, with a similar thing having happened along with a magnitude 6.0 earthquake in 2012. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on September 6th of 2025. As a final note, I would like to thank my YouTube channel member, Joshua Friedman, for supporting my work.